Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hashem said to Moshe, speak to the Kohen, the sons of Aaron, and you shall say to them, let him not defile himself with the dead among the people, except to his kin, to whom he is closely related.
Barukata Adonai, no day na Torah. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, our God, King of the universe, who gave us the power of truth and set everlasting life in our midst. Blessed are you, Lord, giver of Torah.
Like it was shared. Thank you, Adonai, that when you say,
and it is a race that is personalized. It's not like the human race. This is not the race that is before us, is not the Olympics. This is not all of us on your marks. Get set. And we all have this finish line in the back somewhere, a quarter mile, half mile, mile, whatever it is. But we're cooking it as much as fast as we can. And the one that reaches the finish line first wins. That's a human race. That is not the race that was set before us. The race that was set before us is a personalized race. Because the finish line is a spiritual thing. And the finish line, like for Lou, what victory looks like for Lou is different from the finish line, the victory of Bob's race or Cynthia's race or anybody's race. It is a personalized thing. We tend to view the race as like a race towards God's holiness. Because God sets the holy standard pretty high. He sets the holy standard pretty high. About as high as it gets. In fact, we were reading in the Torah portion, be holy because I am holy. And even in the end of last week's portion, it's you shall not do this, I am the Lord. You shall not do this, I am the Lord. You shall keep my Sabbaths, I am the Lord. You shall not oppress the orphan or the widow or the stranger, I am the Lord. You shall not commit sexual immorality, I am the Lord. A high bar. But religion is a race where we're all just seeking to attain that level. And because the reality of it is, and God knew this before you were created, like if God's level is like at the top of this screen, if that's really like his perfect holiness, if that's the level when he says, be holy, for I am holy, you know, I'm going to make it this high. Somebody else is going to make it this high. Somebody else here. Somebody else here. Somebody else way down there. Do you understand that? Yep. We all have our walk, our journey towards this. And when we accept the Lord, we do accept, you know what? We're going to adopt your ways. Because the ways of the world have lied to me. The ways of the world have deceived me. And I'm going to commit to doing things your way. But we're only going to make it so far. Somebody here, somebody there. And religion, it is religion that says you're doing better than this guy. It's religion that does that. We strive to be holy. We do. We strive to be perfect. We strive to be righteous. The Spirit convicts us and says, you know, you're not doing that right. That's got to change. And then like 10 years later, we listen. At least. Or sometimes we don't listen. Ah, you know, I'm kind of okay anyway doing it. Until like 15 years later, and then we kind of listen. Kind of. You know, we all kind of get to that point. We want to do it. We strive to do it. And we succeed at some, we're good at some. Boy, I can stay away from pork chops pretty darn well. Until I go to the restaurant. Was I talking too loud? Until I go to the restaurant, and I'm like, oh, I think I'm just get some meat sauce or something like that. And, you know, and then like I look more closely at the menu. It's like, yep, beef and pork. Like, oops. You know, I mean, I can wear my tzitzit hanging off my, you know, there are certain things you can do pretty well. You know, but it's not just about doing, you know, God started with the Ten Commandments and he kind of gets into our head. You shall love the Lord. Okay, I can do that. Honor your mother. I can kind of do that. You know, thou shalt my hoops that I just covet. So, you know, we tried to get to a certain point, and we commit to doing that, and that's a good thing. But it is only religion. It's not the spirit of the Lord that says the guy that's up here is doing better than the guy down there. Because at the end of this thing, we have a race that God has set before us that is personal. And God has a finish line, a victory for the guy down here. That when that finish line is crossed, the angels rejoice.
Amen.
The kingdom shines over that.
Amen.
That level is real easy. Woo! And I tell you, the guy over here, when listening to religion, will see the angels rejoice over the person going over this hurdle. And he says, why aren't you rejoicing over me? And he says, you have not reached your destiny yet, but this vessel has reached his.
Amen.
Yeah, we can do this really well. We can do that really well. We can stay away from this, or we can stay away from that. Tell it to the drug addict. Who has a finish line from God, which in the natural looks like it's down here. But at the end of the day, it's the same. You know why? Because when Yeshua said in the spirit, it went to the writer, to the prophet, that all our deeds are like filth. He levels the playing field. And the relationship between God and man changes, can change because of mankind's sin. It changed with Adam. It changed with Eve. You know, I was reading some Jewish writings about like what life was like in the garden pre-sin. And it was interesting. It says, you know how like when Adam sinned, like, and all of a sudden their kind of eyes were open to, you know, this, and they grabbed skins, you know, like to cover themselves. So they thought they were naked. Like the rabbis say, you know what skin that is? It's our skin. Before that, they were all light. It's interesting. So the relationship changed. We see that when God was coming down in the Ten Commandments and gave it to Moses and they sinned with the golden calf, the relationship changed.
Right.
We see that the first temple was destroyed, the relationship changed. We see when the second temple got destroyed 40 years after Yeshua died, the relationship changed. The rabbis say like the Shekhinah, the glory was all in the temple, and when it was destroyed, it scattered everywhere around the world. And then we have to seek it and find it. So the relationship can change, you know, because of sin. But the reality of it is that Yeshua became that sin. So then the level, the race that we are running, whether we're here, whether we're here, whether we're here, whether we're here, makes no difference whatsoever. Yeshua became sin so we can take on his righteousness. So we are looked at that level. So our identity is not, okay, I can do this sin nuts. I can do this level of right. I can keep this mitzvah from the Torah. I can't keep this one. You know, where am I, Lord? That all goes down the toilet. It goes down the toilet. And I'm not saying we don't strive for it. We strive to live righteous lives. You know, when he called us out of the world, he calls us to live a righteous life. He doesn't tell us that initially. There was just some evangelist who told you, you know, your life sucks because you don't have Jesus. So then you're like, okay, I accept Jesus. And you're suckered into the kingdom. Now you're not going to change your life. How many of you were suckered into the kingdom? Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, hallelujah. You're suckering us into the kingdom. My life sucks. You got to believe in Jesus. Okay, I believe in Jesus. Aha! You're in. Now there's no way out. Now there's no way out. Now the Ruach HaKodesh is going to work in you in ways that you've never even experienced before. But it's no longer about our level of righteousness in that way. We strive for it, but that is not our identity. All of it goes down to the floor. Yeshua is the righteousness, and we tag onto him.
Hallelujah!
So now the level that the Lord brings us to is our individual potentials in him.
Thank you,
to raise up, rise up, activate within us. It is how are we becoming more like him. It's not about, oh, I did this one good, I didn't do this one good. I tell you, when the sinner who does everything wrong, there are 613 commandments, mitzvot, in the Torah, I tell you, the sinner who does every single one of them wrong, when he reaches that level that God has ordained for him, there is rejoicing in heaven. And every level, every milestone is just a building block to what else the Lord is doing in you.
Thank you, Lord.
Reaching your potential. Your potential. Your potential. Not his potential. Not her potential. Your potential. That may look very, very different in the natural. But there's somebody who God sees the potential. And the potential is that he just stays in his house and doesn't. Say it again. The religious will say, how is he getting his reward? And I tell you that his reward is greater than many of ours. Because he has crossed that finish line that God has ordained, and perhaps we have not. It's not about the two-dimensional levels of holiness, not holiness, where am I? Yeshua, it says in Romans 8, fulfills the righteous requirements of the Torah. So now it's about him being that potential in you, not in him or her. Are you an overachiever? You're an overachiever is that God has something for you and it looks a certain way, it's unique to you. But then you see somebody else who's over here and you're like, that's where I want to be. And then Adonai's got to tell, okay, so you got to go down the path. That may take 10 years or 15 before you realize you were looking at somebody else's finish line in this race and not the finish line that Adonai has created for you. So run the race at God's pace. I think that's what it means when it says with endurance. I think it just means run the race at God's pace. That sounds a little better, I think.
If you don't quit, you win. Right?
If you don't quit, you win. Your race, not somebody else's. Oh, did anybody ever wonder why I'm wearing these shoes? Anybody ever wonder why I'm wearing shoes?
Why?
Sure. Sure, I'm not gonna cover your bare chest. This place is freaky enough. Anybody ever wonder why I'm wearing jeans and shoes and socks?
Whoa!
How many people know that about a year and a half ago? Shoes here. Raise your hand if you remember that.
Yes!
How many people here knew that about a year and a half ago and before that, I used to wear khakis. And not jeans.
I remember.
Does anybody who knew that know why I did that? Give me one guess.
You relate, Rabbi.
Who else was barefoot here? Rabbi Peter.
Rabbi, you're rabbi.
So I come in, I'm like, this is how you do it. I'm like, I got two examples. I got Rabbi Jan Rosenberg in New Jersey, where he wore a suit. I'm not wearing a suit. And I got Rabbi Peter, who wore the white shirt, the khaki pants, and barefoot. You know, and people that know Rabbi Peter, he can be a little bit of a tough act to follow, you know what I mean? You know, I mean, people are, you know, that's okay. Oh, you're the new rabbi now, okay, well, you better keep going. You better do it just like him. Or else I'm out of here. I like it the way he do it. I'm going to sit back over here and see the way he do it. So I'm like, no problem. I like the way he does it too. Hallelujah, here's my bare feet. What do you think of that? What do you think of these there bare feet? And my khaki pants. That's a start. And then I come home and I go, I'm not the same as Rabbi Peter. And like Susie, who's like the Holy Spirit in my home. Yeah, she's not listening. She's just doing her online shopping. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, you can see. Who? Oh, Zoo Lily. Oh, there's a package at the door. Can you get it? And I'm like, I just suck at this rabbi thing. Why can't rabbi, you know, go like that? You know, for a year and a half, I'd come here, yeah, you know, I'd go home and like, I wish Rabbi Peter would come back. This whole khaki pants thing isn't really doing anything. So finally, the Ruach, named Susie, decides that she's had enough of this whining and me looking at somebody else's finish line and not my own.
Thank you, Lord.
And she goes, put your damn shoes off! I mean, no. Put your damn shoes off! What? Put your damn shoes on! What in the world are you talking about? We're home and I have my slippers on. Put your shoes on!
But that is not our identity.
Our identity is Him. You were created in the image of God.
Thank you, Lord.
And Yeshua, it says, is the visible image of the image of God. He fulfills that. So He took care of sin. He took care of the identification with the levels. He took care of the relationship based on the levels. Because He kept Torah perfectly. And became sin. So your identity is righteousness, not sin. So now we can be three-dimensional, multi-dimensional with this race. And we can see out of my, where are you bringing me to? Where are you bringing me to? Where are you bringing me to? Not him, not her, not my kids, not my mom. We word curse ourselves very much, don't we? Oh, we word curse ourselves.
Why I have a bad temper? I'm Italian.
Oh boy.
That's why I have a bad temper. I'm Italian.
Your lineage doesn't identify where God wants to bring you. God has a destiny. These words are being repeated here, that God has a destiny, a vision, a finish line for you. And the good news about these finish lines, they're just stepping stones to other finish lines.
Yeah.
And it's a glorious walk. He took care of sin, gave us his righteousness, and now we're on the journey, the race at his pace of becoming him.
Amen.
And when we, if it's the drug addict saying, I'm just gonna stay here, I'm gonna just stay in my halfway house. What is it that the angels rejoice? Father, help us to reach that point. The destiny, the finish line that you have for us, that is unique to us. Run the race with endurance that was set before you. That unique race. Oh, it's a glorious walk. It's a glorious race. He's bringing you to things. I mean, you can't recognize a flower when it's just in the seed. You can't recognize it. You can't recognize it. Until it goes underground, it goes deep, it goes hidden, it goes into dirt, it gets covered with soil. It gets stepped on. And then it just starts to, roots start to grow. And the seed that was planted all of a sudden comes forth. Do you know that the head of the flower is the seed? Do you know that the seed that was planted comes right out of the ground? Do you hear what I'm saying? The seed that was planted, when there are roots built, the seed itself comes out of the ground.
Yeshua.
The seed that was planted, when roots develop, the seed comes out of the ground, the exact same seed. Thank you, Adonai. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for the journey, the race, the walk, the limp. Thank you, Adonai. Thank you, Adonai. Thank you, Adonai. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The journey is unique to each of us. The journey is unique. Aviel has a unique journey. Aviel, Zachariah, Glover.